Guys, Fort Camden Meagher, very Irish name, named after Irish men. And this is the entrance. It is a Sunday, it's open, the weather is lovely, and I think you're gonna enjoy this exploration. It's not a free site, I had to pay in, but hey, it is well worth it. And there's a lot behind those walls, and there's even more outside of those walls, because from here you have amazing views of Cork Harbour. Yeah, Cork has one of those harbours. And I hope you enjoyed this vlog today. It's a little bit longer than usual, but if you don't have time, watch it in parts, and I'm sure you will learn a lot. And if you stumbled on this channel, hit subscribe, and you'll see more videos of Ireland, Cork, and everything I go to explore while living here. Elena here from Are You in Ireland. Thanks for stopping by. Hi guys, so we're in, it's quite sunny, but there you go, 65% of the fort is on the 45-acre site. Gives you the idea on the map. And some military presence here. So we are lucky to get in, even though their website says they're not open till end of May. But usually I don't like paying for sites in Ireland. You know, I'm big into free things to do. And I've written EBooks about it. So I feel there's so much in Ireland that you could discover for free. Of course, you know, a lot of you come to Ireland for the Guinness and, you know, the Blarney Castle and all of that, and that's fine, and I've done those too. But nowadays, I luckily don't have to pay to a lot of attractions because I know what's available. Yeah, they've done a good job here. They've put a lot of money. The attraction is busy, so I didn't mind paying €5 today. Plus, it's a nice day to walk around. This place seems huge, and I have time. Yesterday was a complete washout, so it was Saturday, but today is Sunday, which is also unusual for a touristy site to be open on Sunday, but, you know, it's good for me and for my husband. So what we plan to do is just to walk around here, and yeah, so this is kind of like a cluster. The area is Carrigaline, Crosshaven, and Ringaskiddy. They all kind of positioned very close together, and it's looking out onto Cove. So the Cove is in East Cork. You might have seen my video about Cove. That was where the last stop of Titanic was, and before it sank. But so also a village, a town worth exploring. And then here, we usually come here for the beaches and the walks, you know. No, I must say we've not been here over the last 5 years that I've lived in Cork. I've maybe been here but 4 or 5 times. So that's average, just once a year. And I am here first time this year, and it's end of April. So, it's a nice area, you know, and sometimes you can spot nice boats. So I'm gonna go up and see what the fort has to offer. Enough of the water scenery for you. So straight up you could see Cove. Well, anything that you can't pick up. A bit of land in the cathedrals and Coleman's is Cove. And then between it's Pike Island, and behind that is another island, which is a naval base. And like there on the left is where Ringaskiddy is, another part of Cork where, you know, you can see a lot of office buildings, and the oil and production is all pharmaceutical. So you might know that Ireland But 90% of pharmaceutical companies worldwide have headquarters in Ireland, and some of them are even in Cork. So they kind of spread between Kinsale, Ringaskiddy, and Little Islands. Some of them are in Dublin. So there's a bit of useless information about our job scene, but I'm gonna go in now for sure, see if we can get in and explore the fort.
Okay, we reckon that this is where they brought the missiles along. There's quite a number of lookouts, sort of hidden, I don't know. Looks like a train station. And there's a track. It would be cool if they actually done it up and did like a kid's sort of train here. Really good. If they actually did this like a little train station, like a shop or something, or a cafe, and then they had a little train here, mini village. I saw that in other countries, you know. And also they do something similar in Clonakilty, the railway museum in West Cork. Quite a number of abandoned sort of derelict structures, houses here. We are in a part where we're not supposed to go because there's a fence, but you know, nobody's gonna throw us out, hopefully anytime and now. And we can get back. I just wanted to have a look and explore above the ground, not under the ground like they mentioned on the plaque. There you are, we are very close to that pier now. Interesting place. Not all complete ruin.
Hello guys. This appears to be the tunnel. Woohoo, scary. And it turns. And I think I know why we're not supposed to go here. Because it's quite long. Okay. Okay, I'm just gonna show you. For people who like scary things and exploring, bring a torch. There we go, that sounds like a... It looks like a scary movie. And there we are. Out into the world again. Okay, better go and see what's the rest of the fort has to offer. So here, guys, it tells you a little bit about the Spike Island. I have visited there. I did not make a video when I did visit it. We might go there again in the summer, who knows. It's a lovely kind of island. So, and it's good to, you know, you can take a train from Cork City to Cove, and then from Cove you can take a boat. So for anybody who doesn't drive or who's not driving, it's still a site within the reach if you are visiting Cork and looking for something different, you know. So specifically you can explore Cove and then head to Spike Island. It's not that expensive at all. I think it cost you about a tenner for the tour of the island and also the boat, which is a short journey really, maybe a couple of minutes. But yeah, you could see it, it's right there. It used to be a prison up to 2004. And now there's various buildings there to discover, and you can also see some art exhibitions, and there's a coffee shop on the island, so it's a nice kind of walk. I enjoyed it anyway when I was there, and there's a lot of history there too. And then there you go. Anybody heard of Brennan Torpedo? Anyway, if you're interested, you can look this up. I'm not going to read the plaque for you. And I'm going to head down to explore the fort. Yeah, 65% on the ground.
The sun keeps coming and going today, but it is a much nicer day than yesterday. Yesterday was a very, very Irish day. It was wet, windy, and very cold. Although we had a lovely week prior to that, you know, April in general was quite nice and mild, but yesterday was very wet and we didn't really do anything. Which kills me sometimes because I love my weekends for exploring. I do nothing else. I have no family to visit in Cork or anywhere else in Ireland. And my weekends are for exploring and doing fun things, and then I share them with you guys. So it's a nice time. And yeah. For many of you who don't know, I've been in Cork for about 5 years now, and this is pretty much all I do at the weekends. I go and explore different areas, sites, ruins, I write ebooks and my blog, and I share it via social channels to show you how much it is really to do in Cork. And in Ireland in general, we're not always stuck in Cork. We do go out to other counties. I'm particularly biased, I suppose. There's a lot to do in West Cork, and I love going to West Cork. Look at all the ruins here. But East Cork has as much to offer, you know, if you heard of Jameson Distillery and such, you know, that's all East Cork. Ballymaloe House, Shanagari, and huge pottery workshop, that's all East Cork. But West Cork, of course, has a lot of celebrities living there, and they have a lot of castles that they bought and restored. It's actually amazing how much wealth is located in West Cork. You wouldn't believe it. Yeah, and the average price of the house in West Cork is about €500,000. That said, it's probably because there's so many period houses and castles for sale there, you know, and you could probably buy a house not that expensive, you know, if you're looking for a sort of retirement home or something like that. Or a lot of British retire in West Cork, and I know why, because the place just offers so much, you know, good quality of life. So let's see, there was an old railway here going back to the fort. I feel like this is going to be not a very short video, but short enough. Look at this piece of old equipment. Where do you see that? And then the old pier over there with the boat. Must be nice to be able to just sail. You could also hire boats from Crosshaven and do sailing. They actually have a regatta every summer. Crosshaven Regatta, you can Google that. I know a few people who go to it every year. So, nice, keep watching. Elena here from Are You in Ireland. This little fort built this. Some of them used for storage. And the sea's on the right. And then I'm gonna climb this stair. Okay, just to remind everybody, I'm 8 months pregnant. Thank you. I'm 8 months pregnant, but when I was 6, I climbed St. Paul Cathedral steps in London, and that's like 800 steps up and down, and I managed that, so that shouldn't be an issue at all. I'm more kind of curious where it actually leads, so I'll see you at the end. So here we are at the top. Come out here, guys, and there's a cafe, probably with a view, because the sea is right there. So we're gonna go in and get some water, and then continue exploring.
There is a bit more to your cafe. So what's this called again?
This is the furka. It's a version of the fur of a marching pole. There's a couple.
Very heavy.
Some guys do it slightly differently. They might be a little bit taller, or with leather. Mm-hmm. We have a version of that here. But everything you need, you carry. So everything on that table, with exception, is coming on your person.
And there you go. Good lecture. There, guys. Place is full of characters. And then we have a baby changing room. Royal Engineering building. And actually, where we were just now, it's a sort of a museum. Quite busy here, guys, but this is the engineering office. And there's we're finally at the cafe part. There's so much to see here, and the guys there really tell you all about the stuff that they used back in the day. It's really interactive for kids. And there's finally somewhere I can get some water. What do you know, guys? The cafe has a deck with the best view so far in Cork. It's €5 entry to the fort. You could and another maybe coffee or whatever, you could be sitting here enjoying this amazing view. Definitely worth the entry price. Quite a lot of exhibitions in all this little, I'm not gonna film them all, but just to give you an idea. The Rescue Camden story. So as I've already mentioned, it's opened in 2010. And there's some restoration photos here on the display. Quite impressive. I love those I love this sort of spaces. So obviously a lot of work has been carried out by volunteers and local community. It's Kalash. But it's cool. So the fort is massive, and it was built in 1500, and obviously it served over the years Irish forces, and it was a property of defense forces. And this fort first opened in 2010, and there has been few additions since. This is my first time here, although I did try and visit it before, and it was just very busy. But beautiful cafe with a terrace, and this is the first one I've been to which has no smoking terrace in Ireland. For some of you, it might be crazy to hear, but although smoking is not allowed inside places, most of the terraces at pubs and restaurants allow smokers, which is really annoying if you're having your meal, or if you're a non-smoker in general, or like me, you're pregnant and trying to avoid smokers at all costs. So it's been really nice visits, and explored some tunnels. And we also been kicked out of one of the things that we're not supposed to see, the tunnels. Apparently it's very dangerous, but we managed to get some shots on the video. There you go. The one that looks very scary, it's not open to public. And this is the magazine fort that we've just been through and carrying on. So, place is full of history. There's gunpowder magazine, which will tell you all about it. Quite a large spaces. I actually love it. I love being in spaces like that. Just huge, open, and kind of empty. Sort of like a gallery without the art. But there's a barrel. So guys, I'm in another part of the galleries, so I just thought I'd mention, so 1550, the fort was called James Battery, but it was renamed to Fort Camden in 1795, sorry, and now it's of course called Fort Meagher, but what's interesting here, you might have seen me at the Brennan Torpedo. So there were, in 1893, there were only 8 installations worldwide of this torpedo. See, and this site was one of them. There we go. This fort's claimed fame. Also, Ballincollig powder mills mentioned here. And Ballincollig village is where I live. So you might have seen my video about gunpowder mills. So we have a very historic village as well, and I've done a video through the gunpowder mills in the park. You might want to check this out. Just I'm gonna put the link down below, and so there you go, James Battery. Very, very impressive place, considering they basically have done a lot of work here by locals. Well worth a visit. So guys, right ahead here is another fort, Fort Carlisle. It's not a tourist attraction, it's actually still functional fort for the army. And I was told the only way to visit it if you enlist in the Irish army for 3 years. I'm a bit old for that. You can't be older than 25, not even a day older than 25 to enlist into the Irish army. So how do I know that? Because I tried when I was 25. Yeah, long time ago. And it's been quite great here. And there are tour kind of guides around that tell you about things if you ask them. And also they're quite children friendly, as I mentioned. And this is the building. So it's a bit different to Charles Fort. Completely different setup, and obviously Charles Fort, it's mostly self-exploratory and also a lot smaller in my view. I must head to Charles Fort someday again and film, because when I visited there I didn't make a vlog. It was just a very hazy and rainy day, and I didn't do anything other than photos, but also worth to visit. And we're just gonna carry on and explore. It's actually probably the busiest tourist site that I've been to in the last year or two, which is great. You wanna see those places busy and visited by people, you know?